Hello dear children, in the last video we have studied about proper and improper fraction. Today we are going to study about comparison of fraction. What is this comparison of fraction means? We are comparing which fraction is greater, whether 2 by 6, if you take these two, which one is greater, whether 2 by 6 or 5 by 6, we have to identify now. Now, so for that what I will draw one. I will take one circle, here also one circle I'll take because we have to compare, so we need two. So in this I'm going to do how many parts means? Six parts I'm going to do. Okay, six equal parts I'm going to do in both the figure. Now you see 2 by 6 they have told. So in the first figure I'm going to consider only two shaded portion. So in the second figure, I am going to take how many? 5 they have told. Numerator is representing that number of shaded portion. So, I am going to take how many here? 5 parts I am going to collect. I am going to take. Okay. Now, can you identify in which figure you can see more shaded portion? In the first figure or in the second figure? This is first and this is second. So, in the second figure, we are seeing more shaded portion. Hence, this figure is greater than this one. See, for example, if you wanted to paint a circle which is having six parts, in which figure you need more paint? In the second figure, you need more paint to color the 5 parts compared to the 2 parts. Is it? Hence, which fraction is indicating numerator is greater, that fraction is greater than the other one. So here, compared to 2 by 6 and 5 by 6, 5 by 6 is greater than 2 by 6. If you take 7 by 9, 5 by 9, again in this figure, numerator is greater. Hence, I can say 7 by 9 is greater than 5 by 9. Okay, like this we can just compare when the denominator is same. If it is 3 by 7 and 3 by 7 means, we can say that both the fractions are equal. This is about comparing fraction. Next comes addition and subtraction of fraction. Addition and subtraction of fraction. This is very easy. How means? When the denominators are like fraction. Like fractions means denominators are same. Like fraction nothing but where the denominators are same. If I take here 8, here also must be 8. Then we can say this is the like fraction. So here if I take a fraction 3 by 8 plus 5 by 8. So it will be 3 plus 5 is equals to 8. Okay, when the denominators are same, don't add 8 plus 8 is equals to 16. Don't write here. That is completely wrong. When the denominators are same, so we have to write denominator as it is. As it is means how 8 is there, the same way we have to write 8. If, for example, 12 by 15 plus 1 by 15 is there means, what is our first step? We have to check whether the denominators are same. Yes, of course, these are the like fraction, hence the denominators are same. I am going to write the denominator as it is. 12 plus 1 is 13. If it is subtraction means, for example, 10 by 5, is this proper or improper? It is an improper fraction. 10 by 5 minus 8 by 5. Both are improper fraction. 10 minus 8, if you do, you will get 2. 2 by 5. Again, denominator, don't subtract 5 minus 5. I will write 0. It is completely wrong. 5 minus 5, you should not do. Denominators, you have to keep as it is. That is 2 by 5. If you take one more, that is 20 by 100 minus 10 by 100 if you do. Again, our first step to write the denominator as it is. 20 minus 10 is 10. This is about the fraction revision. Okay. Now we will move on to the next lesson. That is lesson 11, geometry. This is also there for your periodic test 2. Okay. What all we have studied in the geometry part? First one, we have studied a point where point indicates only position. The tip of this pen, tip of any object we can say that is a point. So it always indicates what position it indicates. Position means, for example, if I take a circle, if I put a dot at the center, means we can say this point is the center of the circle. Okay, this is the center of circle. So this is represented any alphabets we can use to represent the point. Next we have studied line. What is this line means? If it has no ends in both the direction, it has no ends, line has no ends, if it can extend up to infinity, then I can say this is a line PQ. Line PQ where there is no end. Okay, it has no end points and it can extend in both the sides. This is line. How we are representing line? PQ we have to write, and at the end we have to show, at the top we have to show just line. Next we have studied line segment. What is this line segment? A line segment is also what? Is a part of line. It is also a part of line, but it has both the ends. That means if arrow mark, I'm very sorry, here arrow marks will come. Here arrow mark will come. So this is extend up to infinity. Here in the line segment, it has ends. It will not extend in both the direction. We can count the number of points here. It has two ends. So we can identify the number of points in between this line segment. If we are counting through computer or anything, we can count here. So here fixed points will be there for some distance. So this is, if I say x and y, so I can say how to represent this line segment, xy, xy. This is line segment. Next, if we come to ray, what do you mean by ray? Ray has only one end point. It has one end point. In other direction, it can extend. In one direction, it can extend. And one has it end points. If I write this, if I take this point A and this one B, always we have to see ray is looking like an arrow. Okay. In which direction it is moving, in that direction only we have to read. So how to read this one? So read ray AB. Here we can read line segment XY or line segment YX we can read. Here line PQ or line QP we can read. But in a ray it is not like that. We have to always read ray AB only. If you want to read from here to this side, means that time we have to draw a figure like this. So that time we can say ray BA, that is the at B to A it is moving. Here from A to B it is moving, like that it is about ray. Next comes angle, where two rays meet at a one point, and I mean two rays have a same end points, then two rays share a common end point, means we can say this is angle. If I say this is R P Q, means we can represent angle R P Q where a common end point is there. This is called vertex, that should be written always middle, or we can also write Q P R R P Q, but vertex should be middle, where the common endpoint is there, that should be always written middle, Q P R. This is about the basics. I hope it is clear. We will see some more concept in the next video. Thank you.